When it becomes official on Tuesday, Ndamukong Suh will be the fifth non-quarterback to get max money contract of at least $100 million. If he does get $60 million guaranteed, that would mean Suh would have made over $100 million in guaranteed money over his two contracts. You may remember he got $40 million guaranteed in his first contract in 2010. And here's an interesting note. The Lions made a competitive offer, $58 million guaranteed, but in order to compete with Miami, Suh needed about $65 million from the Lions in order to make it even. So here is the question, now that we know he will be the highest paid defensive player in the league. Did the Dolphins overpay for Suh, Stephen A?
I do not believe that they did. The Dolphins, first of all, let's understand some things. Number one, in the AFC East, the New England Patriots have owned the division. When we've seen bright spots from the Miami Dolphins, it wasn't because of their offense. It was because they had the ability to punch you in the face, to really come at you. But you also have to, you also lamented the fact that it wasn't continuous, Skip, that it wasn't something that was reliable, that they did continuously. Well, how do you change that image? By getting one of, if not the nastiest brother in the National Football League, in Ndamukong Suh. And when you think about this kid, Cameron, and what he's capable of doing, particularly with the attention, the push that Suh is going to give you and the attention that he warrants, it's going to free Cameron Wake and those boys up in a way that is going to make the Miami Dolphins defense lethal. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm talking about lethal in terms of the pressure that they're able to apply to the running, to the quarterback, and their ability to stuff the running game. Yep. They still have some work to do. But it is clear, Stephen Ross, give credit where credit is due. He has definitely doled out the dollars. There, you can't knock him for that. I mean, they got to revisit the whole Mike Wallace situation, giving him $60 million, $10 million a year. You might have to revisit him because he hasn't earned it, to be quite honest with you. He can play, but he hasn't earned it. But in the end, what it comes down to is that I think they're nastier. I think that they're more formidable defensively. And I think when you look at what a guy like J.J. Watt is getting paid here, I mean, he's got a $100 million deal. He's got over, what are he getting guaranteed dollars? $55 to $60 million?
Suh's is the highest.
I understand he's not J.J. Watt, but that's because J.J. Watt plays the end, and he's allowed a freelance a little bit more than Ndamukong Suh. Those in the football community tell me that the attention that Suh garners is what frees other dudes up to do. He's not the guy that you're going to look at numbers-wise and say, wow, the stats knock you off the charts. Yeah. But what he does for you is very formidable. The only thing that I want to say is this, Skip. The other thing is you get overpaid in free agency. I want to reiterate that point. And when you look at the Lions, I'm trying to give this brother Martin Mayhew every benefit of the doubt. He's been in the organization about 14, 15 years, been at the helm for the last 6 years. How do you make the initial offer to Suh? From what I'm told, the initial offer was only $15 million, $15 million a year.
It came to the table later, but
the initial offer was $15 million with $45 million in guaranteed after Suh had been hearing all year long that he was going to get paid more or just around what was getting paid. So you bring that initial offer to the table, so you open the floodgates for him to be pursued by other teams. Then you look at some of this stuff. They could have cut to this kid that injured his knee for jumping up like a fool and coming down and hurting himself, embarrassing himself that way. They could have cut him. They didn't do it. You had Coach Caldwell loving Suh, and Suh loves him, so he didn't want to leave because of that. You had Megatron that said he would do whatever it take in terms of restructuring or whatever to keep Suh, and they didn't do that. Stafford, for some reason, there's an APB out for him with all that Suh has done for him and others. Nobody heard from Stafford in terms of his willingness to step up and restructure his deal. If I'm wrong, I apologize, but everything that I read, everybody that I spoke to said they didn't hear anything from Matthew Stafford in terms of his willingness to restructure his deal and make sure Suh got his money. So I'm thinking about all of these different things, and I'm saying to myself, how in God's name could the Lions allow it to come to this, especially, Skip, where CAA represents Suh. They also represent Watt. They also represent Stafford and Gerald McCoy. So they know where the bodies lie as it pertains to the numbers. You don't let that happen. You don't let this situation regress to that point. That's why he's a Miami Dolphins, in large part because the Detroit Lions didn't come across as an organization who wanted him until it was too late. And they dropped the ball on that.
I am not with you on this one.
Okay.
I did say before that draft, I would take Sue number one over Sam Bradford, in large part because Sam Bradford couldn't stay healthy when he was at Oklahoma, and I'm obviously a longtime Oklahoma fan. So I was right about that.
Okay.
And I'm going to be right about this one, too.
Mm.
This is way, way, way too much money to pay to any defensive tackle, especially one who doesn't bring that Reggie White intangible. Remember, Reggie White was a lightning rod who attracted free agents to, of all places, Green Bay, Wisconsin. Mm.
Okay.
Remember that?
Yep.
In the Brett Favre era?
Yeah.
So Sue is unto himself. Is that fair? He's kind of his own man. He's not a team leader. He's not a rah-rah guy. Again, I've talked to a lot of people in
so
around
have I,
Detroit.
But go ahead.
Okay, I don't see him as that lightning rod leader who will attract other free agents as an intangible to Miami. So unless you tell me that he's a defensive end and a pass rusher or a left tackle or a cornerback or a quarterback, and remember, right now, only four quarterbacks are going to make more than Ndamukong Suh. Only four this coming year.
Yeah.
Only four quarterbacks make more. That's preposterous to me. I can't compute that. Because as big a force as Ndamukong Suh is in the middle of a defensive front, and I'm with you on what you say about Cameron Wake and all the it makes them formidable. But so was Detroit.
Yeah.
Weren't they formidable?
Yeah.
And in Sue's 5 years, the Lions missed the playoffs three times. Is that all his fault? No. But did he change life in Detroit? No.
Mm-hmm.
They missed the playoffs three times. And in the 2 years they made the playoffs, off 10 and 6 years, they went to New Orleans and got destroyed after the 2012 season. And then you know what happened to them when we were in Dallas.
Yes.
Remember, they went and played at Jerry World and lost that game 24-20.
Mm-hmm.
So those he had two road playoff games in 5 years.
That was
years
a pass interference, by the way, but go ahead.
That's a whole other issue, but you could be right about that. But fair and square, the Cowboys won that game. Was it Sue's fault that they lost? No. Did he change the scoreboard that day? No, he could not, because he's a defensive tackle. So I think that Detroit fell into a good thing here. I think that Detroit will benefit from losing out on Ndamukong Suh, because it will allow them to start to plug all their holes, to fill all their weaknesses in ways the Dolphins now will not be able to. So I ask you the bottom line question. Now that Ndamukong Suh is the highest paid defensive player ever, not just this year, ever in the history of pro football, does that make the Miami Dolphins a contender to win the AFC East? I say no.
Yeah,
I'm saying no.
Wait a minute, Skip. In fairness to Ndamukong Suh, you're not saying that because of him, Skip. You're saying that because of Ryan Tannehill,
Thank
who
you.
You've never been a big fan of.
Okay, but they
you're
got a shaky that, offensive line and shaky receivers.
Well, I'm saying they got shaky receivers.
Yeah.
They got a shaky offensive line. In your estimation, they have a shaky quarterback. But, Skip, I got news for you. They also have the 24th ranked defense against the run.
Okay.
So you've got an Ndamukong Suh that helps plug up the run. You're already formidable. You are ranked sixth against the pass, Skip.
Okay.
So another words, what you're doing is you're taking care of the defensive side of the ball. If you're getting dudes off the field, you're giving your offense more opportunities to do what they do, and that helps. Then not only that, you also know this. You've also said defense wins championships. When you are nasty and you are intimidating, that is something that resonates. Now, you might look at the Lions, but we all know as an organization, the Lions have been pretty much an embarrassment, at least up to the...
I'm not talking about the last
couple of years or so, but I'm just saying, Sue helped change it. They didn't make the playoffs two in the last 5 years, but I'm saying, remember how awful they were prior to that? So let's give credit where credit is due in that regard. And then you also got to take this into account. If you think about the Lions, this is a guy that, from what I'm being told, is still going to count. Sue's still going to count about $9 million against their cap. Because they restructured him. And guess what else I heard? I'm hearing that the $60 million may all be paid within the first 2 years.
Okay.
Which is insane.
I don't see how you can't count that against the cap.
I don't know how. That's just what I was told by somebody. It was like, hey, listen, it's in the first 2 or 3 years is when he's going to get his guaranteed dollars, because most of the players want it up front. We'll see if that really is true and that materializes. But in the end, all I'm saying to you is let's not look at Sue and say, well, he didn't do this, he didn't do that. The Lions defense was one of the top three defenses in the NFL this past season. Sue had a lot to do with that. And they get definitely against the run, and Miami is ranked 24th against the run. So if you help shore up your defense, then that's going to give your offense more opportunities.
Okay, I hear what you're saying, but when you pay that much money to one defensive tackle, and you're already sort of an 8-8, 7-9 kind of team to start with.
Yeah.
Where are you going to go from there? How are you going to get that much better? How are you going to rise up and challenge Tom Brady and company?
Listen, the best way I can answer that, Skip, not being disrespectful to anybody, but there have been a few instances in the NFL where Super Bowl contenders and, dare I say, Super Bowl champions leaned almost completely on their defense. The quarterbacks were perceived as game managers, individuals that managed a game. They weren't necessarily playmakers and difference makers, but the defense was so elite, it carried you
there. Is he Ray Lewis? Is he the leader?
Well, first of all, nobody's Ray Lewis, the leader on the football field, but the point is, you never know how formidable he's going to be for an already respectable defense. And in light of that, who knows what Miami is going to be because of it. I think it's a chance worth taking.
Yeah, I think they got a little better, but not a lot better.
The question was, did Miami overpay for Sue? And we were trying to figure this out. He has $60 million guaranteed. Next behind him, J.J. Watt, $51.8 guaranteed, and then Gerald McCoy, $51.3. So, yes, he is the highest paid defensive player ever. When we come back, we're talking about my MVP choice, Russell Westbrook, with another triple-double. What does that all mean? But Steph Curry, though, still making it look easy and showing the league why he's the front runner for the MVP. That discussion a little later on in the show. And you guessed it, the boys are back. So there's a lot to talk about. You want to know what it is? Head over to our Instagram page. You'll find out. We'll be right back in just a few moments.